nature of retirement into seclusion, meditation, and concentration, yes, that lead to loss of self.
For putting those both in the cover.
Mm-hmm.
That should do it.
We will translate that to mystic.
Did it sound as though it was close?
It's probably pretty close, mystic,
return the cleaner, right?
What?
You return the cleaner?
Worldly consciousness.
Hold on, I'll have to come out and hear that again.
Okay.
Running around doing this and that. Yeah. It will be remembered that,
what else?
You return the cleaner.
Yes.
Right? Will you put the, continually
so
uploading that we started yesterday?
Okay, there's just one more.
Just one more, huh?
The first hour and a half went up last night.
So great. Here,
and then you put up the last half hour and stuff.
Oh, you don't have to do that.
Oh no, I set that up yesterday. They're both done.
No, what I'm saying is, when you do your work this week, you do not have to do Archive 21 because we did it.
Right, no, both, all 2 hours of it are already up. The one up last night.
Yeah, what I'm saying is that we did it here, and you don't have to do it
anymore. Right, I didn't even take it with me, yeah.
What?
I didn't even take this archive with me.
Yeah, right, good. Good, so that's been done. All right, read me off.
Right, meditation.
Four bottles of vegetable oil, right, thanks, pea soup, three. M&A's, graham crackers. Right. So they were graham crackers made in China?
They can be, yeah.
Triscuits.
I love doing this life energy doing the battle.
Saltine, bleach,
and the life of Katama is extinguished. Katama was his family name, his name before he became enlightened.
Walk down on the socks and the shoes, right?
Yes.
The truth has taken up its abode in me. And we know what the truth is.
I want you to take a look at them sometime. Yourself, so you know what fits you and all that.
I'll go to Oddlot.
There is no evil.
Red Pantry's okay?
Yep.
Utility cleaner? Staples?
Yep.
And did they have any tripods?
I don't think they do have tripods.
That's on your list to look for.
And
two jugs of gasoline, thank you. So you don't know if Staples have tripods, okay?
I don't think they do.
Thank you.
And that's where we are.
Thank you.
You could turn those around and say them positively instead of negatively.
No.
You could say, we seem
happy
to
feel
happiness,
and
new happiness. Or you could say them, no unhappiness.
And then now I have to pay you for gas.
Do you? I thought you had a credit.
The body is Gautama.
So do you have enough gas in your tank?
I did. I put $20 in for myself today.
And it was.
Okay.
And this one will be too.
You were right with that?
Yeah, that's fine. Just count that down, your credit, to $4
So I don't have any more credit? No.
Something like that.
All of erase my credit.
Sure.
After which nothing survives.
I just gave you $4, okay?
Another self. No other self.
You're
and no other
yep.
self.
I just gave you $4.
And one can then say that the blessed one is here or there. It is just as with a flame in a sea of blazing fire. It has been, but it is gone. The flame has vanished, and one cannot say it is here or it is there. But wait a second, he goes on later to say that what is left is the good that we have done, the karma we have done. We'll get to that later. End of the quote. It is the anticipation of the experience of nirvana that sustains the Buddha during the return to life in the world. Cut that out. I'm not interested in the return to life to the world. I'm not interested
Thank
in the
you.
Future, the
and
present,
you
of
the
being
gas
happy.
No, you only write on the side that the credit is erased
sure.
or something like that.
Glenn used up her $7 credit.
The present, live
yeah.
correctly, assured a perfect future. The world has disappeared. The truth has taken up the whole, the abode in me. The body is Gautama's. It's due time. It will be dissolved. So back to... It is the anticipation of the experience of nirvana that sustains the Buddha during the return to life in the
Thank
world.
You, Devin.
Yep.
Between the supreme enlightenment at the age of 35 and the entry into final nirvana 45 years
see.
Later. That makes him 80 years
Customer
old.
Customer seats.
All the misery of the
what
world,
day?
All the annoyances of administration of
yes, yes,
sir.
December 30th.
All
okay.
the
amount in numbers, 12
and
20 cents.
Calumnies are slanders.
And how much?
$2.20.
By heretics and dissenters, sort of like
this one's also from yesterday, and it's $21.
But it didn't take away my happiness. I was still happy.
Okay, $21.
To him, a radiant light. Here we are, folks. We are a radiant light.
That would be
the of happiness
Buddha,
and a flaming faith
yeah, Buddha,
that the end
right.
is in bliss.
Okay.
Eternal
really
peace.
Sent the camera to Chicago for $20?
That's right. That's how he taught us to die.
Is that what that is?
Excuse me, I'm going to get
no.
up and see some kitty cats want to come in out of the 18-degree weather.
I guess I
it's a good
what
winter,
was the receipt?
$21?
Would that be stamps?
It says stamps, yeah.
Oh, excuse
Damn,
me.
Sanctuary.
Okay.
Right.
All right, stamps. It's $21.
Happiness.
Okay.
Right.
And then, next one?
I'm not finding a date. It says dubs 4, half hours, DVD.
Oh, that would be yesterday.
Off to DVD. Okay.
That would be Los Alamos.
Yep.
And how much?
No customers.
What's the portion? Oh, it's a dollar and a half money order.
Right
is all that we're looking for.
Oh,
that was that's, awesome. Yeah, there would be money orders. Okay, how many money orders do you have in your hand?
This looks like the only other one, so it's two.
Any more?
15A, 12, 11, 10.
Nope, these are all the suits.
80.
There's some others.
Just say that again.
$1.10 now.
That the end is in bliss, eternal peace. We won't contemplate the end because we know it's
four.
Going to be perfect if we keep the present perfect.
Five.
The spoken emphasis is nevertheless on cessation, deliverance, extinction. Okay.
Alrighty.
Quote, there is, O monks, unquote, he was sent to the
money
disciples. An escape from the cycle of the born, the originated, the created, the constituted, for there is neither unborn, uncreated, and unconstituted. I don't get too excited about that. It is a state where there is not earth or air or fire or water, neither space nor awareness, neither perception nor non-perception.
That is $96.45 instead.
It is the uncreated, it is the changeless. The eternal
stamps?
Does not originate.
Okay, that's
posted.
Do not there is the extinction of suffering. Okay.
Well, how much was it?
$96.45.
That's okay, if that's what he wants. I think I can get along without that.
Okay.
I think that I have found
some more receipts for money orders. This one is another $20.
The thought and the effort and the life into, and that's the happiness.
else for life.
The presence of
heaven. The donation receded.
The Buddha Gautama left indeed little room for description of the blissful state. That's unfortunate.
The...
You should have had a microcassette recorder.
Oh, no, December 4th.
Thank you.
We should have had an amanuensis. Somebody write it down.
Okay.
The one of December 23rd. It says TWR.
The doctor's
That's $4.
Donation receded.
Extinguishing, experiencing power.
$4.
Perhaps it would be...
I got it.
$4 to Fairpoint, December 24th.
It's completed.
This is the emphasis upon the absolute, not on the I. But he would have helped the I. He would have helped people.
Received $1,000 cash for the postage and diet instructions, so that's me.
That's okay, that's postage.
That depends on how much you got back in change. I didn't open the envelope.
To have written down steps.
Well, it was fine, Devin.
And it's
so $50 for the diet instructions and make whatever amount of change back.
There's a receipt there. You can come to it.
Okay, so that'll probably be here somewhere instead.
Yeah, you gave me a receipt.
Every step of the way, God will tell us what to do.
Oh, so that should be one, two, three, four. That's this thing right here underneath.
The absolute that you got. Immortality.
Oh, that only cost $9.50, so you had back about...
Finality. And I think that we're getting there. We are there. I don't know whether we're getting there, but we are there.
And that was what...
The average mystic. Now that's the important thing. Mystics are classified as to...
December 22nd.
Yeah.
That's strange. The average mystic of other faiths, though taking out of himself the average experience of
on December 28th.
By the way, that's what we've got, isn't it? That's what we've been looking for. Union with the divine.
$1.15.
Look forward. As a self, to further blissful experience
this one's
of that
December
union
28th.
In this life.
And it's extremely difficult to read since I think it's like a good
print. Oh, it's awful difficult. It's probably just an addition. I don't even think it's a receipt.
Oh, okay.
Because this is a receipt.
Yeah, it's a receipt. That's not a receipt.
Yeah, put that right in there.
All pointing, however, to final absorption.
So were these all the all the programs you shipped out the day before I did?
You know what this is? This is the insurance for the camcorder I sent.
Oh, okay. But they also say Stuyvesant Falls, so that's where you take the ones when you ship them, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Usually. Sometimes Kinderhook, sometimes Malaysia.
Absorption, prepossession.
So here's one for December 30th.
I wanted the insurance. What was it?
Better price to us folks.
You said this thing here's the insurance?
As Nibbana as it is in the Pali of the time,
this is
of such importance meant before the Buddha gave it a special religious or mystical
and the postage is $9 and insurance fee is $2.75.
A total of $11.75. It was used in the sermons to denote the extinction of the flames of lust. Yep. Happiness will do that for us. Lust, craving, anger, happiness will do that for us. And the light in the life of the Arahant. Okay, so we got rid of lots, we got rid of craving, we got rid of anger, and the like. But, now this is kind of nice. Shortly it came to mean the whole process of final liberation. Liberation from everything evil, unpleasant, unhappy. We are liberated, folks. And we are emerging into illumination. That's what it says, an emergence into illumination. We are either there or we are getting there. Deliverance, we have.
And it's
emancipation, we have. Salvation, we have. Enlightenment, we have. All this is required in term. Okay.
Priority postage for $4.95. December 30th.
Either we have it or we're going to have it. What do you think, folks? The Blessed One made a distinction between Nirvana and Final Nirvana. It was Final Nirvana, which is coincident with death, or the final passing from mortality. We will have we will have Final Nirvana if we continue to do our Nirvana in the present.
And here's another slip that says $11.75 for a priority insurance. Did you send two things that were insured?
No.
So these are the same.
Can we continue our...
And then these little cards.
I need that one for the, the last patient you gave me just before that one.
$4.95.
Now and we'll have happiness in the end, and it's the same happiness.
Is this something, or is this just your accounting?
Yeah, if you read those to me, it's if I go.
Extinction with death, or the final passing from mortality, that Mara, the evil one.
765 priority.
$4.95.
Yeah, can ignore that. I can't read the second part, though.
Okay.
But it is interesting how Guru was tempted and Christ was tempted, remember, in Matthew 3 or 4.
Priority, that would be postage.
$8
to Susan
Kitty Cat. Okay. It says $6.80 PP. Is that priority postage?
Parcel 4.
Parcel 4, okay.
In the moment of the Great Enlightenment.
And so that would be to end.
Are we in the moment of the Great Enlightenment?
Okay.
Or are we approaching
it? There's a $5 charge reading Victoria telephone.
I feel pretty much.
Oh yeah, we said Victoria the
there or almost there.
That was $5.
I don't
and
think I could
have 75 cents.
Really. What about yourself?
Deliver something? Delivery?
And then though, it's radiancy.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
It's postage.
Yep. Radiancy.
And $4 DCTV.
Nice thing.
And that's the end.
Maybe we're there, maybe we're not there.
That looks
maybe
like
we're
it,
just shared when we're talking to each other like now, but when we get out with people, we lose it.
Alright, now then there's all these.
He then knew its radiancy, its bliss. He was granted insight into the oneness of all that is. Yeah, that oneness. That oneness, God, that's so great. That you, God, oneness. We're all one.
What would you say next week?
$30 for Janine Renew.
Yep.
That's right. That would be a technical equipment. She
even if you go into physics.
Okay,
geology or whatever were made from the original elements that you made out of electromagnetic waves.
Someone in Chicago.
Which you
are. Yeah, that would be that would be
insight into the oneness of all that is.
That's a
conceive the relationship of cause and effect. Saw the way
it was yesterday.
And the truth capital T.
Thursday,
and we know the truth.
$20. Got it?
This one says send money for Harry.
There is only God. God is good. Everything is good. There is no evil.
Next one says Jack $2.
Pure bliss. Pure happiness.
I know who that was. Not Jack. It was
but
Jack.
But he then drew back from finality of absorption. Well, certainly. I can't see.
The back of this card says $4 St. Luke's December 8th.
I can't see what good that does it.
First of all, donation.
And that's kind of self, isn't it?
Unreceded.
Oh, you think it does God good?
No date.
Okay, maybe.
Okay, that was Tuesday the 24th. Okay, and now according to St. Luke,
he then drew back from finality of absorption and get on to the business, which is
and then,
living happiness.
Oh, I entered that. Oh, honey, I entered that. That was
check
for the lights. And what's on the front of it?
That's Jeff. Jeff and Cindy.
Well,
okay,
I know.
And this can be thrown away.
Okay.
$7 Betty and
okay,
Betty and something.
No, that's technical equipment.
Happiness by meditation.
Betty and
your heart is pure, your heart is clean, it's full of happiness.
It was how much? Seven?
$7.
Is there
a date?
Nope.
Okay.
Which penetrates.
Did you already write down Mr. Claus so somewhere?
No. Five steps of
okay
preparation.
What we
hear me out, folks. Are we preparation or are we there?
Well, did you, this has $100. Did you return 60 of them?
Document that may or may not be based on authentic utterances.
Print them?
That's good, anyway.
Nonetheless,
it's a gist of interest. It begins, quote, first is the meditation upon love.
Wednesday.
That's what we'll do tomorrow morning, okay?
And,
at 4:30 a.m., meditation upon love.
Okay.
This one says $100.
In which your heart is enlarged. Oh, what a lovely, lovely concept. Your heart is enlarged. Until it longs for the well-being.
And it was St. Luke's. Okay.
And the happiness.
I think this is Omar, $4.
That's right.
I wanted that
and I'll give you a staple.
Until your heart longs for the well-being and the happiness of every living being. The cats, the dogs.
You dead dog?
Until the
cats,
rabbits,
the, dogs.
The skunks, the raccoons. Until it longs for the well-being and the happiness of
Alrighty,
every living being.
You know what that brings up to today?
Including the well-being and happiness of your enemies. Indeed, I have all the people in the courts, the crooked lawyers, the crooked judges, the crooked clerks, the crooked
today's
litigants. Yes. I have all
the money order fees. You've got three?
Four.
Okay, can you remember that?
And happiness of them.
Yeah, I've been
trying to see
before.
Them the best they could be instead of the worst that they could be, which they were in court.
Yeah. I'll take the bundle away.
And the quotes.
No, you don't enter the amounts because those
second
won't be entered when you're sent out.
Compassion.
All we need from here is a three money
yeah.
order.
Right.
And,
my father was so compassionate and I never had to worry.
How much for the fees?
120?
No, Gary, I don't need those.
You don't need those, just the fees?
Yeah.
60, 60, and 60, so that's $1.80.
Yeah, so that goes into your pile of your
six
done.
The fourth is purification.
That would be $1.80?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Walmart, alright.
Detail, that other prerequisite.
Alright.
So important to mystics of every kind.
Do you want to get the gas here?
Yep.
That's $15 flat in gas?
Gasoline, $15. Now there's a tax on that.
Well, that's automatic. It's automatic.
Gasoline,
before delivering
happiness. The gasoline tax is about.
We're doing what God wants, so we have a
I don't know what the gas tax is.
I got it. So that was a 15 flat next to the 1980.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Truth is the meditation upon serenity.
$15
and as you rise above questions of riches or want.
We got it to come
from
no. Thanks.
We don't want anything. And riches are
1980,
no interest.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Of conquest or slavery.
Well, that cleaner with the bleach is $1.37.
No.
We're free. We don't want conquest.
That's not the only thing on there.
Of love or hate.
Are you sure you give it to me instead of putting it in the pile?
Right.
You face your destiny. I don't believe in destiny.
Packaging TP.
That would be office supply.
Hey, packaging TP
is
$5.88.
Is there any more office supplies? Can't we commingle them?
Oh, sure.
I do not think so.
The only one here.
Add them up. Packaging tape. The magic tape.
God is
the
extemporaneous.
The Scotch tape
God
and
goes
tape.
From one
you mean
to
the
another,
tape?
Yeah.
Loving it and enjoying
the
it all the while.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's
and we will try
thing.
To
the thing I added up with. Oh.
Attain an intelligence so that we can share
people.
God's
yeah,
enjoyment and fun. Creating.
Yeah, this
no
has
difference.
Both the household and the business on it.
Yeah,
okay.
There's
some
mistake,
indifferent
right?
to self.
Good.
Yeah.
$5.88, $4.97.
Oh, yeah, that's what Be Perfect is all about. The book Glendora wrote in 1967, Be Perfect. It's all about calm, tranquil, in peace, sure. Don't you love it?
$10.95.
Are you excited about it?
For
that's the initiate.
For the tapes,
are we initiates now? And
how much tax is that?
Are we still initiates if prepared
Office
to enter
yeah,
into
that.
The limitless light of truth? Are we there? Is that what we want? The limitless light of truth? Unbounding. Boundless light. That's a nice concept. We carry the boundless light with us. We see everything.
That would be 86 cents.
We see everything.
Tax on household or on
business?
That's what we were mentioning a second ago.
Office supplies?
Office supplies.
Again, there
cents?
Is a listing mm-hmm. of the four stages of contemplation or. Okay. That's the end of page 83.
What you haven't given me yet.
It took 35 minutes. Is that reasonable?
I'm going to put it through. That's
okay.
Water cans,
put
some
that on the bottom.
Cans.
And some other.
What is it? You're telling me catnip? All right,
we
chat.
We will go 84 and 85 in this
You're not through with the payment, right? And that receipt. You're not through with this one.
No, I'm looking for the paper. Because the paper is not on the ream of paper.
Where do you think it's
I was wondering if it got rung up. Oh, here it is. Okay, fine. Well, I thought I hadn't rung it up.
Wait, you want me to put it down, paper?
Now, do you want to put the joy books in your office supplies?
Yep.
Okay. Then, yeah, that's what this is for.
So we'll do office supplies again? And we won't add them up. We'll do them separately.
Well, I can add them all up now.
No, I got one to go by the receipt thing. What's this receipt say?
That's the two joy books and the copy paper.
Okay, that's office supplies. What's the amount? Right on the receipt.
Oh, yeah, what am I thinking? $12.41.
Okay, and what's the tax?
$0.09.
12/11/10, Saturday.
735A. I'm sorry about the tax, office supplies. What is the tax on the office supplies?
99 cents.
Okay. I am going to go explore the road.
Take that to some England one.
Between Route 9 and
the office supplies. 1088, and you're going to give me the tax on it?
86.
That's 86
cents. Alrighty. And now the cleaner. That's going back.
The cleaner's going back. There's also the other household things that are around here with the spatula, Angel Soft,
this
and
is
the
household.
Gloves.
What they've done to.
Well, this is household, alright?
Engrave it.
Yeah, the.
Is it good?
What's it called?
The
weather strips,
yep,
the doors, the Angel Soft, the gloves, and the spatula. Oh, the other half of this
one. What are your other earths like?
So they make.
What are the creatures there? What are they
doing? Is that coming in? Did you come in there?
Yeah, they're in with the tape, that's all. The tape went together with them.
The world. You've got enough to take care of here yourself. Oh, okay. But I was just wondering if in the other worlds. Is everybody happy? Is everybody living right? Is everybody doing those five things?
$11.03.
The love, the compassion.
For the households.
The joy.
Thank you. And the tax?
And the serenity.
Well, the tax on $11 would be 88 cents.
88 cents.
I got it.
I just wondered if they were perfect, that's all.
So that's those to the office supplies in the household.
Okay, now where's the cleaner to go back?
Yes, the cleaner's on top of this.
We miss it by such a wide margin. Mm. We are a new person's happy, aren't we, folks?
Do you want to put me on there?
New person happy,
yep.
New person happy.
Just a minute.
New person happy.
Well, I've forgotten. You're not exactly technical assistant, but then
new
the way
happy.
You are.
New person happy.
I know what
new
you
person
are.
Happy.
You're travel.
New person happy.
That's the $7 in credit, yeah.
No.
That's not travel?
This is travel, when you did the errands. That's 20.
20, okay.
We filled up God Tape 6, Michael Confess 6.
Continue
on
7. Alrighty. And that was
the day after the
first Friday. And then, I didn't give you any gas, did I?
You just presented the $7 in credit.
Yeah, now let's see, do you think that I... I think I ended that when I paid it, $10. All right, that's done.
That sounds right, I think. Then here's the technical stuff, DVDs and the batteries.
Okay, technical equipment.
That was $83.67.
DVDs and batteries?
Yep.
And it was what?
$83.67.
That's 84, and the tax is $6.69.
$6.69.
Thank you.
The litter pans, catnip, and the brush, all the cat stuff.
That's gifts.
$9.09. Yes.
Gifts. Litter pans.
$19.09.
Yes, you got a lot of money, Doctor.
Okay, we're doing worse.
You have to pay a third of that.
$19.
Already?
Addition.
And the tax on that is $1.53.
And
Were you going to stick it in the deep state? And then I was going to put them in the...
A death. This is what you were enjoying.
Repeat.
You took the cat stuff down from $19.09, right?
Well-versed.
And the tax on that is $1.53.
Well-versed.
The automotive, the two dry oils, is...
Automotive.
Well-versed.
Yes. Is $2.74.
That's
$3. Tax on that is 22 cents. Here's the staples receipt for the...
Okay, that's
kind
of
what
we're
It was 29.99. Yep, that's what it appears. Making the tax $2.40. $2.40. Then the food. All the groceries, yes. The juices, the cooking oils, the flour, the triscuits, the biscuits, the saltines, the pea soup, oranges, produce. That is a total of $78.99. Well, that's the total of everything. Without the tax, it's $78.94.
That's 5 cents.
$78.99.
And the tax on the request is
5 cents.
Yeah.
I don't know what in there qualifies for that.
Okay, I think we're done, aren't we?
The requirement equal to or commensurate with the requirement.
Okay, we're all done. The last thing that we have to do is this. I'll show you how to do this.
Do what with them?
We have to assign them. Tell them. We're going to assign them. Tell them what days to play what months.
Oh, write the dates on them?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And what is the other
one? I'm not going to staple the money orders.
Oh, no. May I have the money orders separate, please? Thank you.
He's such a big cat, and when he gets on the desk, he comes with the drug ones, the words, the microcassette recorder. That is enough, which satisfies the desire or needs they want. Mother, that is enough, which satisfies the desire or needs they want.
Spread these out, I'll give you.
Daddy, that is enough. Which satisfies the desire or needs some want. Lenny, that is enough which satisfies a desire or needs some want.
Okay.
What if people have the same number?
Park
77.
Add
on it. Are they each 2 hours?
They appear to be, yes.
So we make it 7A?
Well, they have different program numbers, though.
Yeah, 7A, 7 and 7A.
Nope.
Okay, here's the other contraction sign.
Empty.
9774. At the bottom, what does it say? Birth what? Number.
Model. Unfound.
11, I believe.
Right.
11?
Okay, so that goes up to 10.
12.
You had 12 already.
Really? Okay, which one is there over here?
12. 59, 59. By date, this one's earlier.
Yeah. Okay, the later one would be A. Thirteen.
Okay, that's
14.
Let's put 1, 3, 4, 6, 7, 14, 14. 15, 16,
15, 16, 16.
Could
you use an 18?
That can go in.
2 18.
16. Oh, okay. These are the same day. This rotor number's higher, so we make this one later.
Can you use a 19?
That can be after, yeah.
And a 20, and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, now .com.
That's it. Let's
spread them out.
This is December the 14th.
Thank you, Lee.
Partnership Day.
Alright.
Good shoot. There were even movements and organizations inspired by the idea of living only for the will of God. Brother Lawrence was, in all senses, a humble servant.
Good. Now we missed the third because the New York State Public Service Commission and the Public Service Law says you have to give them 72 hours.
Conversations.
So can we count today as can we start our count? Can we, yeah, we can. Can't we?
Together,
we're handing them in today, Friday, the 31st. It's Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. That's 72 hours. All right.
Hours for what?
One may speak of him.
Oh, a notice. To cablecast your program. You have to give them 72 hours. All right, so that would be January 3rd. Mm-hmm. Now you might have to have two dates on it. So
yeah, that's room for another one. January 3rd.
Okay, January 4th.
Church man.
My next one, right?
Mm-hmm. January 5th.
And strike no spots of recognition.
January 6th.
Yet.
January 7th. Now you start a new week.
In a curious way.
Right, January 10th.
These conversations have survived, have been frequently repeated, and have been internationally 14. Circulated.
Oh wait, 14 correct?
14 in just the way.
Yeah. That's of right. The well, there's 2 weeks.
January 17th.
Tower to King, or Bohm's The Way of Christ. Like Glaucer, Lawrence was single-minded, selfless, unworldly.
That is correct.
Like Joseph Bohm, he was sweet of character,
saintly,
and wholly devoted to God.
24th, this is Monday.
The book, quote-unquote book, of his sayings, happily entitled, The Present, The Practice of the Presence of God,
the 18th, the 19th,
reveals
the 20th.
And
oh, I wrote 2 18s.
And mystic warmth.
18, 19, 20th.
Okay, that was
first.
Worth reading twice. That's page 287. Brother Lawrence was humbly born. His activities during the 1640s and 50s are complete.
Now, January 1st goes into next month.
To record. As
we're
pertaining.
Done. I'm going to give you these.
searching for his path of devotion.
Did you do that right?
In order?
And entered the parish monastery of the Carmelites.
So you did it right.
Probably in 1666.
And you did these in order, did you?
Mm-hmm. That's the, yeah. It goes this way, then it's over top and goes that way.
No, in other words,
was able to carry on
paper that they report
with a blessed solitary attaining to God's presence. My, what an entertainment that is. Habitually, quote, schooling the soul only to find
S.S. Glendora at WRGB.
And his first illumination
that's
and his
ship
finding of peace.
Yep, that's the ship for but SSG.
Practically all that we know of his life and his writing from that period.
Yep.
Okay.
And you might find somebody there to pick him up.
What?
You might find somebody there who will give you last month's.
Yeah, hopefully.
I am both.
All right, then. That's all.
That's all.
All right. Well, I'll see you on Thursday.
Yes, Thursday at what time? You'll be back to school, right?
Yep.
You'll be back to school.
Well, I guess
thank
we
you
can
very much. Are you, does that take care of everything?
Our whole business,
yeah.
And God's will is
happiness.
And the
fine.
Computer's all set, right?
Yep, those are all done. Alrighty.
Okay,
so
got
the
coat?
From the mystic's oneness of mind. Mm. Of his single, humble, and intimate devotion. Of his living in the felt presence of God, living in the felt presence of God. It's so simple, so touching. One feels in reading the utter sincerity, candor, and generosity of Brother Lawrence. His soul is alight with the sense of the divine in all things. Hooray! That is certainly the truth. The sense of the divine in all things. That is oneness. If he is asked to serve in mean and small ways, he acts as happily as in large matters, because to him it is all God's work. Because to him it is all God's work. And that's the end of page 288. His consciousness of divine presence is no less when he is employed in the kitchen than when he is before the altar. Hey, I like that, don't you? In his character, one feels a native sweetness and an unconscious sunniness. Well, that's good. We live on Sunnyside Road.
You won. You won the day. Boy, you needed 5 more blue sky preservers to help you. That was an awful blast of poison. And here's a new one up here. And this one coming down there to the south. Who pays for this? This costs money. Who's behind it? See, it starts as a streak and it spreads out and spreads out and spreads out. And the blue sky preserve had it all blue here just as a couple minutes ago. So he'll work and get rid of this too, this poison.
It's 9:15 on Tuesday morning, and I'm going to the church today. I will cut the rest of the booklets and bring them to you, and bring you your $60, okay? And I should see you before too very long. I have to get up and around and get myself ready to get out, so it'll probably be just a little afternoon, okay?
Glendora, happy book.
Early afternoon, I see you, all right?
Mr. Paul Claus, Santa Claus. Glendora, happy book.
Press 3 for advanced options.
And it surely did
press
happen, and it's over
repeat
and
the current
accomplished.
Message. Press 6 to...
Don't do that.
Oh, Glendora, this is Pastor Stonis of Church of the Bible in Plainville, Connecticut. I received your phone calls. Sorry for the delay in getting back to you.
Pastor Stonis.
Did get your a copy that you sent me of one of the previous sessions I did. I have not yet received a call for anybody that says they have been...
me either.
...seen me on TV or...
Is anybody out there watching?
I'm sure that it's being on TV.
You're a wonderful creature.
Anyways, I'm hoping to get to some this week to film myself again. I don't know if you're... I'm assuming you're probably running out of the lessons that I've done, so I hope to get to some this week and get those sent off to you. So anyways, if you need to get in touch with me, I'll be here this week at the church. You can get in touch with me usually anywhere from 9 to 4 or 5 o'clock. I should be here. Okay, we'll talk to you later.
Thank you, Pastor Stonis. Three baby lines.
Press 4 for the previous message. Press 3 for advanced options. Press 5 to repeat the current message. Press message 3.
Hi, Glendora, it's Kelly. Your Christmas card just came back, and it's saying Tinderhook. The address I have is Box 124, Dent, New York, 12075. I don't know what to tell you.
The post office forwarding got mixed up.
Press 4 for the previous message. Press 3 for advanced options.
91.
Press 5 to repeat the current message.
Incoming.
Press 6 to play the next message. Press... last message.
This is George. Give me a call when you get a chance. Bye.
I did. Or he did.
No more messages. Press 4 for the previous message. Press first. Message.
Hello, that's Paul.
Message deleted. Message 2.
Hello, Glendora. This is Pastor Stonis. Search the Bible.
Message deleted. Message 3.
Hi, Glendora. It's Kelly. Your Christmas card just came back, and it's saying, Tinderhook.
Message deleted. Message 4.
Hi, Glendora. It's Kelly. Jim and Kelly. I mailed you a Christmas card, and it came back saying last name S-U-L-L-E-R, and then it has a yellow tag on it that says four time expired. One time, I don't know. You know, I put on it box 124, Ghent, New York, and it's got sent back to me. My uncle cannot do the thing anymore because for the past, he doesn't know if he's even going to be in the house. So, you know, he can't do it no more. He's too much on his plate at the time. All right. Talk to you later. Number 631-730-7901. Bye.
Press 4 for the previous message deleted. Last message.
This is George. Give me a call when you get a chance.
Yeah, we did that.
Message deleted. No more messages.
Isn't he big as a raccoon? I thought he was a raccoon the first time I saw him 2 years ago. Out there eating the food. Look at that face.
Thank you.
to be done on that. Here's the open original. We have to make 5 sets. Okay, to whom are these 5 sets going? Gregory? Andrew Horstman? Mr. Schoonover? Marjorie Dugan? Did we mention Gregory Watford? By Knopf. And we're having the joy of reading about Brother Lawrence. His sweetness is not on the sentimental side, for the man had dignity and reserve. He constantly, moreover, translated inspiration and benevolence into deed. What a beautiful sentence. He constantly, moreover, translated inspiration and benevolence into deed. He praises consistently the life of adoration and consecration that holds the soul in communion with God. He praises constantly the life of adoration and communion that holds the soul in communion with God. But the greatest base is given to the idea that adoration and consecration can be expressed in and implicit in what? Work. Did you get it? He speaks often of the simplicity and purity of the heart, quote unquote, the simplicity and purity of the heart. Let's work on it, the simplicity and purity of the heart. Come from these rather than from mental decision. The quote way unquote is to be found quote by heart and by love rather than by thought unquote. Well, I'll certainly agree with that, won't you folks? God flashes the light of faith and the sunshine of his presence into the heart of the humble. God flashes the light of faith and the sunshine of his presence into the heart of the humble. And, quote, if you would go forward in the spiritual life, you will do better to leave aside the labored conclusions and the subtle reasonings of the unguided intellect, unquote. In this he is, of course, the perfect intuitive. Yes, I will go with the intuitive approach rather than the reasoned approach. What would you do? Go unlettered, perhaps educated not at all beyond reading and writing. Brother Lawrence achieved spiritual. Education. When a Monsieur Beaufort, a grand vicar, had been directed by the Cardinal, Cardinal de Nouvelle, to put into writing some of the spoken ideas of Brother Lawrence, he betrayed his own surprise that one so lowly sound wisdom and exceptional powers of expression. Folks, where did that come from? Who gave him that education? Was it in school? No, it was God. God gave him all of that. Surprise that one so lowly born, unfixed, and menial work should exhibit as much sound wisdom and exceptional powers of expression. Where did it come from? It came from God. It came in his times of solitude, his times of prayer, his times of commerce with God, his times of companionship with God. God educated him. Quote, what he spoke, unquote, Monsieur Beaufort records, quote, was very simple. To the point and filled with sense. Beyond a somewhat rough exterior, one encountered singular sagacity. That's a nice phrase, singular sagacity, and one will when one goes to God. First thing in the morning, alone time with God. All the wisdom in the world starts to come in. Back to Brother Lawrence and back to Monsieur Beaufort. Singular sagacity. A range of mind beyond that of the usual humble lay brother. And a penetration far surpassing my expectation. A man of affairs. Capable of giving wise and safe counsel. Surely you must have known that this year before. Oh, by the way, end of quote. ...... The wise people are the people who listen to God. Lucy upon four brought down a good deal of the matter of the conversation. Wait just a second. In Brother Lawrence's own terse economical sentences. And there are extant 16 letters, all but three, written to a religieux of the Carmelite order. That would be somebody in their hierarchy. Exhibiting, in general, the same, end page 289, hold on, we have to help.com here, hold on. So, I help.com with her ears, and I help Sebastian with her ears, and that is a good feeling. And I love reading Brother Lawrence. So we were going to try to find page 290, right? Directions, directness, brevity, and pithiness. From this sort of writing, not intended for publication, he at times to efforts to, quote, commit his thoughts to paper, unquote. Usually he tore up the compositions when he saw how inferior they were to the inspiration he had had from God. Now that's interesting, isn't it? God has spoken to him so brilliantly and so forcefully, yet he couldn't transmit it to paper. That is a feeling that you have experienced, don't you think? God speaks to you so brilliantly, so beautifully, and then when you put it down on paper, it has lost its marvelous luster. Quote, lacking God's greatness and goodness, unquote. But the manuscript of a small sheaf of maxims was found among his letters after his death. With man as with God, he exhibited a rare balance of humility and confidence, of well-giving, of self-giving and independence. With man as with God, Brother Lawrence exhibited a rare balance of humility and confidence, of self-giving and independence. On the one hand, he insisted upon total renunciation and surrender to God's will. Yeah, I do too, do you? As prerequisite to entering God's presence. Yes. Yes. Back to Buddha, renunciation of the world. Quote, we must distrust our own strength utterly and commit ourselves to his safekeeping, unquote. But he walked with a high head, maintaining a dignity submission to God your business. I am about. And so everything will be all right. To God, he said, quote, I have put myself in your keeping. It is your business I am about. And so everything will be all right, unquote. He refused to enter into incessant prayer on his knees or to carry asceticism over into mortification. For he had schooled his soul until his every intention and every action, quote, his common business, unquote, was a addressed to God, for he had schooled his soul until his every intention and every action, quote, his common business, unquote, was addressed to God. Monsieur Beaufort, writing of his character, summed up his virtues in these words, and then here's a nice long quote, which we'll read the next time. I love every word of it, folks, and I've loved it for 2-3 years. And I would say this is my 4th or 5th time through it. And I would gladly take that squared. I would gladly take 4th or 5th squared to go through it again. 4 times 4 is 16, 5 times 5 is 25. Word. It is now 11:30 a.m. and the sun is trying to prevail over the clouds. Temperature, I guess, is somewhere in the 20s. But it's a fine winter day and a good day for staying warm. Except that I have to go to the Seventh-day Adventist Church and buy vegan victuals for my kitty cat. And I also have to get a money order from the post office for $50 or so to send away and get some vegan kitty kibble from Pangea, which sells non-cruelty products. Non-cruelty products, products that have no cruelty to animals, no testing on them, or anything bad on them. You'll have to sing a hymn. This is your Monday, Wednesday, Friday sanctuary devotion. What's your hymn going to be? Well, let's see what we've got in the book here. We've got crown him with many crowns. I come to the garden alone. Thought of a father, stand up for Jesus. Onward, Christian soldiers. Let us break bread together on our knees. Jesus calls us for the tomb of life. Rock of ages. We've got to find new words to that. Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart. God of grace and God of glory. If we take this one. May thy rich grace and pardon go to our fainting heart. Our zeal inspires. Oh, hear us while we pray. Take all our guilt away. Oh, let us from this day be holy. Let's go back and see what Brother Lawrence said. good brother kept steadfastly in the way of faith. We folks today must keep steadfastly in the way of happiness. Happiness is our business. Our business is happiness. And we have put ourselves in your keeping. It is your business, God, that we are about. And so everything will be all right. Amen. So what's your next business? Stay in the sanctuary. Do the words. Do the joy book. No, the pure thought folder. The pure thought binder. And print 10 pages of guide instructions and practice the straight talk mobile phone 15 minutes and work on Devin 15 minutes. That will finish the sanctuary and tidy the house and try to boost the 1980 so that it runs. Boost it by using the 1993, which did run last night. And exercise the body and then go on to a chat with Glendora. Try to get that up to date. Indeed, Brother Lawrence made clear to Beaufort that the only occurrence that could bring sorrow to him would be loss or the sense of God's presence. But he added, he apprehended no danger in that direction, being aware of God's complete goodness. Don't you love it? Don't you just love it? Quote, Brother Lawrence, unquote, was the name in religion of Nicholas Herman, a native of Lorraine. Nothing is known of his early life except that he was born in the year 1611 and that he came of a family in humble circumstances. As a youth, he fought in the wars waged in the name of the Holy Roman Emperor against the Protestant sovereigns of the North. It is supposed that he served in the army of Wallenstein in Germany. He was severely wounded, and after his recovery, he walked always with a pronounced limp. That's so sad. That is so sad. We make our own trouble. God doesn't make any trouble. We make our own trouble. About the time of his army service, when he was 18 years of age, he experienced his first revelation from God. The disclosure was no more than comes to millions of men, he should say people, each year. The sight in midwinter of a dormant leafless tree, as he gazed upon the trunk and branches in which all life was asleep, he experienced a vision of the tree as it would be in summer. Gorged in countless thousands of leaves were flowers and fruit. And therein he felt a sense of God's power. Yes, it would be easy to do, seeing that. Yes, God, a sense of your great power and bountifulness that never left him. Reflecting upon the leafless tree and God's way with it, he was then and there, he said, quote unquote, converted. He felt that he had been specially favored in the revelation, and he therefore struggled to loosen the ties of the world upon him. Good work. Good work, Brother Lawrence. Good work, Cheney. A great many years later, Brother Lawrence told his dear Beaufort that he had then been kindled with such a love for God that he was not sure it had been increased through 4 decades of living since. The leafless tree, he said, quote, first flashed in upon my soul the fact of God, unquote. From the hour of conceiving that, quote, motion and the scene unquote, of God's peace, wisdom, and goodness. God's peace, wisdom, and goodness. Quote, he had no other care but to reject scrupulously every other thought in order that he might perform each act for the love of God, unquote. Boy, that's something to keep in your mind all day long. These are such good phrases, folks. They are so helpful. And we mustn't stay away from them, you know, more than 15 or 20 minutes. We must go back to them. In the years following his conversion, he worked as a manservant. For a time, he was a footman in the establishment in Paris of one Monsieur, I think it's Flaubert, described as, quote, the treasure, unquote. It is not unreasonable to believe that Nicholas Herman felt a certain fitness in dedicating himself to a servant's work. He said of himself, as regards his employment as footman, that, quote, he was a great, awkward fellow who broke everything, unquote. While Beaufort confirmed this to the extent of speaking of, quote, a rather rough exterior, unquote, he speaks of his keen perception and his goodness of heart, quote, despite his goodness, unquote, he adds, Brother Lawrence was intensely human. Here, that ends page 291. Manner was open and frank, so that one immediately had confidence in him. I think that's terrific. Since the early days of television, that that was the way to be. But you talk to people into the camera, one-on-one, shoulder to shoulder, so that you have to be intensely human, and so that your manner was open and frank, so that people at home immediately had confidence in you. And that has been honed and practiced. And, I guess perfected since the 1950s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and now the decade 2010. How long he was in domestic service event of his mature life is his entry into the Carmelite monastery in 1666. In that year, he was 55 years old. Really? 5 years old. Takes a long time, doesn't it? I'm 82 years old. Look how long it's taken me. And I'm still not there. But I think a week ago we were. Normally blameless or sinless before the incident of the leafless tree. So, also there is only the faintest light upon his way of living in the years between his conversion and his decision to join the Carmelite order. In late life, he often spoke of his quote-unquote sins in that early period, but it is not unusual for saints to magnify the transgressions of their unregrettable, well, just a minute, unregenerate, I guess, days. It's a pretty nice word, unregenerate days. The very purity, this is nice, the very purity and holiness of their existence after illumination and dedication makes earlier lapses, be they only pleasure taken in pleasant food or trim clothing or innocent personal life, the other. Brother Lawrence, so far as anyone knows, may have truly sent, or he may have known only those commoner pleasures of life, senses, commoner pleasures of these senses, in the presence of which the average person spends his life. What do you think of that, folks? Pretty good, huh? Well, why look back? Why? Again, we focus on the present. If the present is perfect, soon the past is going to be perfect. If the present is perfect, then the future is going to be perfect. So, we're on page 292. Mentally and spiritually, he experienced a long period of doubt and tribulation. There were 4 years of trial when, despite his dedication of his life to God, despite his effort to do every act as if it were in God's service, he seemed to fail miserably. Even a temptation. Those who had, quote, resolved to make the love of God the end of all his actions, unquote, he had trouble in schooling his mind to reject desire and vacillation. He was plagued, moreover, by fear for his soul's salvation. That ends the 4:30 a.m. meditation for the date December the 16th, 2010, Anno Domini. And it was delayed, this is 10 minutes to 7, because we are making 20 dubs of Pastor Stonis' dissertation on Matthew 18. But we are glad to do both. Now we move on to the sanctuary. Count blessings, count pure thoughts are way ahead up into the 17,000s. Count blessings and count pure thoughts, 17,000 of them. And next we will do square 2 and square 6. While this dub is being consummated, it's going to the 19 Connecticut TV stations we have. Is it red light?
Yeah.
Not elsewhere. The second day following, he took to his bed for the last time. The final sacraments of the church were given to him. To a brother who was watching at the bedside, who asked him what was on his mind, he answered, I am doing that which I shall be doing through eternity, thanking God, praising God, adoring God, offering the love that fills my heart. On February 12, 1691, painlessly and in peace, Brother Lauren slipped away from his body to enter into a new phase of a long-established companionship. Brother Lawrence's meager writings, together with his reported conversations, Beaufort entitled, perhaps over fully, but with admirable fitness to contend, The Practice of the Presence of God, the Best Rule for a Holy Life. No other arranged title could summarize so well the philosophy of belief in Brother Lawrence. What he had accomplished that is rare, not unique, was to simplify a philosophy of life until it contained in hardly more than a single injection. And to his genius as spiritual philosopher, he added the gift of almost radically apt and simple speech. There is no quotation that can be lifted out of the text and offered as a key passage. Rather, he repeated a central injunction tirelessly in the conversations and the letters in the maxims. Often he leads his subjects with some such simple introduction as this. Men invent means and methods of coming in God's love. They learn rules instead of devices to remind them of what love, and it seems like a world of trouble to bring on to oneself. Consciousness of God's presence. Yet it might be so simple, it is not quicker and easier just to do our common business wholly for the love of Him. Let us be put in consecration upon all we lay our hands to, at the same time establishing communion of our hearts with His, summoning the sense of His abiding presence. There is need of neither art nor science. We go as we are to Him, unpretending, single-hearted. The maxims, perhaps, contain the most concise exposition of the central thought. In the spiritual life, that devotion, which is the most characteristic and most fundamental, is the practice of the presence of God. It is the schooling of the soul to find its joy in divine companionship, holding of humble and affectionate converse with Him ceaselessly. We should so rule our actions that they may be acts of tribute to God, but let them not be studied, only natural, welling up from the simplicity and purity of our hearts. It would seem almost beyond belief if one could foresee the nature of the converse the soul holds with God at these times. He seems to delight so in this communion that upon the soul utterly committed to Him, He bestows joy beyond number, as if He would not have it turn again to earthly things. He provides for the spirit abundantly, thus He gains a divine nourishment in an unbound felicity of a sort beyond human thought or comprehension. And this with no more effort on his part than the simplest sense. Occasionally, Brother Lawrence admits the difficulty of communing unhindered to a consciousness of divine presence, and once in the maxims he lists three ascending stages of passive and conscious union. He concludes the third or actual union of the soul.
That's it. Thank you very much. That was on December 16th at 6:15 p.m. Page 292. On the 17th of December at 9:35 p.m.
Don't you think this is a nice video? Three cats on the bed on New Year's Day.
there is the open question whether his life had been normally blameless or sinful before the incident of the leafless tree. So also there is only the faintest light upon his way of living in the years between his conversion and his decision to join the Carmelite order. In late life, he often spoke of his quote-unquote time, or sins, in that early period, but it is not unusual for saints to magnify the transgressions of their unregenerate days. The very purity and holiness of their existence after illumination and declaration makes earlier lapses, be they only pleasure taken in pleasant food or trim clothing or innocent personal love, seem evil and monstrous. The age was one of violence and of easy morals on the one hand, but of strict, almost fanatic rectitude on the other. Brother Lawrence, so far as anyone knows, may have truly sinned, or he may have known only those commoner pleasures of the senses in the pursuit of which the average man spends his life. You have to be careful how you spend your life. Mentally and spiritually, he experienced a long period of doubt and tribulation. There were 4 years of trial when, despite his dedication of his life to God, despite his effort to do every act as if it were in his service, he seemed to fail miserably, even succumbing to worldly temptation, though he had, quote, resolved to make the love of God the end of all his actions, unquote. He had trouble in schooling his mind to reject desires and vacillation. He was plagued, moreover, by fear for his soul's salvation. We're on page 292, folks. I think we've read this before. But, yeah, many times before I've read it. Maybe 6 or 7. And I'll probably read it again. I was for a long time certain in my mind that I would be damned. So certain that all the people in the universe could not have persuaded me from it. But I found it possible. Reason in this way, quote, I have entered the spiritual life purely for the love of God, attempting to act only in accordance with his will. Whatever shall become of me, whether I may be lost or saved, I will continue always in the path of God's love and will. At least there will be this in my credit, that until death I had put my envy, my every, that until death I had put my every effort into having and serving him. The torture, unquote, the torture of mine persisted for 4 years. And my suffering was acute. But at last I saw that it all came about through lack of faith. Seeing that, I was freed and entered into a life of continual joy. Lack of faith. Lack of faith. He didn't realize that God would save him. Is that what they mean? It doesn't matter. Our business is happiness, and we will continue happiness. Even so, it took him additional years to perfect himself to a discipline that would habitually bring his mind about to God in any uncertainty or crisis. Quote, having given myself wholly to God, I renounced, for love of him, everything that was not he. I began to live as if there were no one save God and me in the world. What do you think of that? As often as I could, I placed myself as a worshiper before him, fixing my mind upon his holy presence, recalling it when I found it wandering from him. This proved to be an exercise frequently painful, yet I persisted through all difficulties, quote. Again he said that he'd been very sensible of his own faults, but that he had refused to be too discouraged about them. He confessed them freely to God, quote, but did not plead with him to forgive them, unquote. After confessing, quote, he went back in peace to his accustomed love and adoration, unquote. He came to the conclusion that, quote, it is idle thoughts that spoil all. Right about that. The mischief begins there, unquote. Right. How many times have we said, count pure thoughts, count blessings. No negative, second, trivial, ugly thoughts. In summary of the struggle of that period and the coming of a second illumination, Brother Lawrence much later wrote to one of his superiors in the Brotherhood. Now we're in the Brotherhood. No women. Let's make it good. Okay, folks? My suffering continued. The feeling that my devotion was not so intense as I wished it to be, the recollection of my past sinfulness, and the great difference between my worthiness and the bounty God poured upon me. Okay, so forget the past. Certainly. Forget worthiness, but that's good about the bounty that God pours upon us. All this caused me suffering. Often I fell and presently rose again. When I had accustomed myself to the thought that I should end my days in this struggle, though it did not diminish my trust or my faith. I was changed suddenly. When I had accustomed myself to the thought that I should end my days in a struggle, though it did not diminish my trust in my faith, I was changed suddenly. What is he saying? Again, I guess it was his faith. His knowing how great God is, and his love of God, that changed him suddenly. My soul, escaping tiresome discussions, attained a profound inward peace, as if it had come to its own home and place of rest. Since that day, I walk before God simply.
Yeah, that's all it takes. That's all it takes. The presence of God. Simply.
That ends page 293. Companies that
the Christian injunctions to work and serve. He told Monsieur Beaufort that when he entered the order of the barefooted Carmelite friars, whether in 1666 or earlier, quote, he had desired to be received into the monastery, believing that he would be disciplined for his awkwardness and his faults, sacrificing his worldly life and its pleasures, unquote. But he found that he need not have troubled his mind in that matter, for he experienced nothing but satisfaction in the monastic life. He did, however, relax and draw away from the routine practiced by the brothers. Before long, he had substituted his own way of devotion, the practice of the presence of God, which formed the substance of the published conversations, for that of the other friars. There are misunderstandings over this, perhaps jealousy and complaints, and one of the most cogent and beautiful of Brother Lawrence's letters is a justification to a superior of his conduct and his manner of adoration. Letter follows. As a novice in the beginning, I spent those hours appointed for personal prayer in an effort to turn all my thoughts toward God. I then labored at existence through bless my by means of reason and the deductions of the intellect than by the appeal of faith to the heart. Thus I came shortly to the sense of God's nearness and to the knowledge that I wanted only to abide in his presence. That's all I want to you two folks. That's all we want. We don't want knowledge. We don't want intellect. We don't want reason. We just want to abide in the presence of happiness. His sense ceased to have meaning for him. Finally, quote, I have quitted all forms of devotion and all set prayers except those in which my position as a friar obliges me. Now my only business is to remain in the holy presence of God, dot, 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 or better, in an habitual, silent, and hidden conversation of my soul with God. A habitual, silent, and hidden conversation of my soul with God. A habitual, silent, and hidden conversation of my soul with God. A thing of joy, an inward rapture, and to be expressed, and not to be exposed before others. Or better, in a habitual, silent, and hidden conversation of my soul with God, a thing of joy, an inward rapture. Habitual, silent, and hidden conversation of my soul with God. A thing of joy, an inward rapture. We are on page 295, midway. 11:10 p.m., December 17th. 2010, Anno Domini. history, politics in the world. God has it. And you're one with God. So you have it. And for yourself, you really don't care. Because God has it. It's a done deal. It's established. It's there. Rich, famous, popular, successful, great. Respected, praised, applauded, admired, cheered. History, politics, and the world. All worlds. There must be millions of worlds. If not billions. In spite of his independence and self-reliance, once he had settled into monastic existence, he continued to rely upon the purging and tonic effect of confession. Quote, I have no need of a director to advise me. He is the best director to advise him there is. For I am schooled to love and follow God in all things. That's what we must do, folks. And I think that's what